Hey guys, today I'm going to be showing you how to build a fused Clapton using one of these guys here. Alright, so I got this off a Russian guy off YouTube. Sorry, a German guy off YouTube, and it just makes it so much easier. Your fingers aren't going to hurt, and it's going to be a lot easier.
I have that top piece here that you've drilled out, as you can see. So you've used a file and just sort of created that space where the wire is going to sit. Okay. Then for the one down here, this part, you're going to take a small spring, or you can get a larger one and just cut it. So you got a spring there and two of these washers. So you can pick these up at any sort of hardware store or anything. You need two of these little guys. So then you take this over here, and you'll get the wire that you want to wrap. So you'll start off first as a spring on this guy, and then two washers. And that's how it goes in. So just like that. You have the spring first, and then your two washers. That goes in there. Tighten that up a bit. Now, one thing about this is when you cut the spring, you might see that it's starting to go over that little knob. Make sure you tuck it back so it's the pressure is being pulled against the knob. Otherwise, you're not going to have pressure. Okay? Now, I'm not going to go into too much detail about the wire itself. Twisted Messes. I'll have a link in the description where he goes over it in the best detail possible. So for today's one, I'm going to be using 26 gauge with, so 26 gauge nichrome. I usually prefer 24 on the inside, wrapped with 34 gauge Kanthal, and I usually prefer 36 on the outside. But it's hard to find in Canada, so we're using these guys here. Going to straighten your Kanthal. For people who don't know how to do that, you basically just take one end. Put into the chuck of the drill, make sure it's nice and tight. Sorry, this is the nichrome I'm straightening first. Just hold it with one end. Give it a twist. That should be more than enough. I just run my finger along for that extra energy that's in the tip. And there you go. Nice and straight. Okay. So set that off to the side. Now there's different ways to work with your spool of nichrome. I'm going to show you the way I do it. It might not be the best way, but it works for me. So start off by taking out your nichrome. I let a spool of it go. Then I'll use something to sort of pretty much keep it from unwrapping too much off the spool. So I'll put like my phone down on the wire. So how you want to do this is you'll take one of your thin wire. So this is the Kanthal here, the 34 gauge. I take it and I feed it up through here. Okay. Just like that. You see that? I fed it up through there. Take a decent amount. I mean, you should have a lot of this wire. I buy it in fairly large pools myself at least. And then you basically want to put it in between those two washers. Okay, so right between those two washers, get it up there nice and tight, and you can give it a bit of a twist now to tighten it down. So loosen it at first so you can get the wire in there and then tighten it. Okay, take my two straightened wires. So these are the 26 gauge, although I prefer 24. Just give it a little bit of a tap to even up one end. And then I clip the other end so the wire is equal in length, and I get rid of those little bends I had. So now the next thing I do is that piece of wire coming off the top of this part with that little engraving as I made. I'll take it, hold it in the end, and just give it a couple wraps around. Okay, wrap it. There may be a better way of doing this, but this is pretty much what I do. And it seems to hold it together pretty well at least. So I put that into the chuck of the drill. Get it nice and tight. I'm just going to give it a couple of turns. don't worry about the wraps at this point. It's going to be all messy, but this part of your wire isn't what you're going to use. Okay, now I got it nice and tight like this, right? Basically, what I'm going to do is, using my hand, I'm going to guide the wire, and I'm going to guide this little jig along, okay? So just let it go. Now what you're going to notice is, part of the spool, if you're doing it my way, you'll have to sort of keep refeeding it. If I cut it all at once and I don't straighten it out, like hold it against the doorknob and pull it, I end up pretty much with like knots and stuff like that, which kink up the wraps. So I found this way is nice and easy. I mean, I just go, like even here you can see it's, I let too much out. It's gonna start kinking up on me. I gotta just adjust. I'm sure there's a better way, but this works for me, so why not? And I just guide this thing along. No problem. Like, these wraps are all coming out fine. I'll give you a close up just now. I'll give this a little clip because I don't need this part anymore. Okay. Bring it up to the end. Now, right there. Gotta stop, so I gotta pull it out. Alright, there we go. I mean, those wraps are nice and tight. See those little twists in the wire? That's the next step to get rid of. I mean, those are some tight wraps. And just a quick rundown of how to unwrap those wraps. All you're going to do is you're going to take your wire. There's Twisted Messes video about this, so you just, I use nylon pliers and one of these guys here, and you just hold and each wrap slowly go along and just twist it back into place like that, okay?
Time moves fast while we're silently waiting. Holding back heavy hearts that are breaking. Cause there's no light in this dark city. No rain to run for cover. No one to blame for what we're guilty of. Maybe I'm the home. days roll by, waking up to a sunset. The empty side makes it harder to forget that there's no light in this dark city, no rain to run for cover, no one to blame.